Good evening and welcome to Act 2 of the Canadian Crystal event, O Canada, the Concert. I'm Catherine Leverett, Chair of the Limestone Learning Foundation. We begin with an acknowledgement of territory. The Limestone Learning Foundation and the Limestone District School Board are situated on the traditional territories of the Anishinaabe and Haudenosaunee, and we acknowledge their enduring presence on this land, as well as the presence of Métis, Inuit, and other First Nations from across Turtle Island. We honor their cultures and celebrate their commitment to the land. Community, mentorship, and forward vision are the cornerstones of the Limestone Learning Foundation. May I recognize the presence of Kingston and the Islands MPP, the Honorable Sophie Koala, and Chair of the Limestone District School Board, Paula Murray. From the presenting sponsor Johnson Insurance to the absolute professional and personal commitment to this event by concert producers John Abrams and Alexandra Mundy Abrams, along with musical directors Tim Stiff and Greg Runyons, the visionary leadership. The visionary leadership has been electric. Then there's the charismatic driving force of the Foundation's Managing Director, Leslie Miles, co-chairs Richard Holmes and Carolyn Close, and their spirited committee of volunteers, but most of all, the powerfully talented, hardworking, and now professional young people that you see on this stage. They are standing together. Your narrators tonight are Andrew Molina and Sydney Van Camp. The Limestone Learning Foundation is proud to work with our school board, schools, community organizations, and sponsors to fund innovative educational projects in literacy, numeracy, technology, science, and the arts, and wishes to thank the Isabel Bader Centre for the Performing Arts for their enthusiastic collaboration.
Thank you, Catherine, and good evening. I'm Deborah Rands, Director of Education for the Limestone District School Board. I, like all of you, am eagerly awaiting tonight's performance with Limestone students honoring Canadian music over the decades. I know how hard these young adults have worked on their songs with the unwavering support of the concert's creative team, and I'm confident Act 2, the O Canada Concert, will be the highlight of the evening. How can it not be? With 40 talented students performing with a band comprised of Limestone graduates and teachers. On behalf of trustees and senior staff, it is my pleasure to extend congratulations to the Foundation's Board of Directors and the volunteers who have given so freely of their expertise and time to produce this exceptional event. I am also deeply honored to be able to extend sincere thanks on behalf of all Limestone students to the Limestone Learning Foundation for their ongoing funding it provides to school projects throughout the year, and for the opportunity the Canadian Crystal has afforded student artists and performers tonight. I have to tell you sincerely that this partnership between the Limestone District School Board and the Limestone Learning Foundation is indeed unique across the province. Please enjoy this special evening of celebration and recognition of our students, LLF projects, and of course, all of you, our sponsors and our guests. Enjoy the evening.
We begin Act 2 with a traditional song and prayer, and I welcome Elder Marianne Spencer of the Mohawk Territory and the Karawakwi Learning Center drummers.
territory. So my Mohawk name is I Sing Out to Creation, and tonight I've been honored to say a few words of thanksgiving before we actually go into these beautiful drummers here. When we think about our thanksgiving as Haudenosaunee people, which means longhouse people, we have a way of giving an address that we call the Ahondagari Wadekwa, the words that come before all others in our thankfulness for creation. And if we think about all the things that happened tonight, creation is the one that brought us all together. Creation is how we got here, as we made our way on the back of Mother Earth across this turtle island. And we see in this room so many different people of all different races and of all different ages and all different male and female people. And we want to send our love out to everybody. So my words wrap you in this warm, soft blanket of thankfulness and thoughtfulness and love. And we have to remember how important our earth is, and to give that thanks to our world for providing everything that we have here. For it's our mother that has given us everything so that we could be here tonight, so our children could sing, so that we could be here and be happy and proud and honored to be in their presence. And all the beautiful water that surrounds us, that life-sustaining force, without it there would be no life. So we have to think about how we can bring our minds, gathering our minds together, and to be thankful for the things that our earth provides for us, so that we can continue to exist here in this world, and to be thankful for all those things. And there are so many things that we have to be thankful for, that here we are, our health is taken care of, we have food, we have drinking water, we have a world that loves us, an earth that will take care of us, a sun that will rise, you know, every morning, and a moon that is so bright tonight. And she's the leader of all the women here. And she wraps us in her love and her light and guides us through our lifetime, our journey here in this world. And I want to say how honored I am to be a part of this evening, and how thankful I am just to be a small little piece in your life tonight. So I say now, Goa, and take care of yourselves. And after this evening, live a good life. Move about this earth in a way that is kind and compassionate. And always remember to be thankful to creation. Yahoo. Thank you.
In 2007, a group of courageous women met at the Kingston Interval House. They wanted to create a better life for them and for their children. Their drum circle created this rendition of Six Nation poet Pauline Johnson's Land of the Silver Birch. Today, we wear these red scarves to honor the missing and murdered Indigenous women.
Thank you. Witch to the Cataraqui Learning Center drummers. Thank you for sharing your music and your teachings. Hello, I'm Cindy Van Camp, one of the co-hosts of Learning in Limestone, a student at Sydenham High School, currently enrolled at LCVI for the Studio LC Focus Program.
And I'm Andrew Molina. Yes, I'm the other co-host of Learning in Limestone. My home school is KCVI, and I'm also enrolled in the Studio LCVI Focus Program. Cindy and I are classmates, co-hosts, and tonight we're honored to be your co-narrators for the Canadian Crystal Concert.
There are just a few housekeeping things before we begin that we'd like to touch on. So tonight's performance will be professionally photographed by Stephen Wild and Wild Photography. We are also videotaping it, so there's no need to worry about when you have to get up to videotape or take pictures of the song. You can back and enjoy the concert. We actually ask that you put your cell phones away. There's no need to worry about the status of your auction items, and emails will be forwarded. The performance hall is engineered so that no data or internet service will be in. Now you will see Jane Douglas roaming around taking a few photos with her cell phone. She'll be posting them later to the LLFDN Twitter and Instagram accounts and the Canadian Crystal Facebook page.
Okay, let the magic begin.
Thank you.
64 song, Both Sides Now.
Belong to us. Oh,
music of the 70s wasn't just about electric guitar protest, at least not for New Brunswick's Stompin' Tom Connors.
Mothers in a dangerous time.
Hollywood gave the world one of its most romantic movies, An Officer and a Gentleman. Canada's Buffy St. Marie from the Piedmont Plains Cree First Nation Reserve in the Qu'Appelle Valley, Saskatchewan, also helped to lift us up to where we all belong.
I'm
Kingston, Ontario. Do we need to say more?
Up on my first real six string, bought it at the five and dime. Played it till my fingers bled. It was the summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Joey got married. Should've known we'd never get far. And when I look back now, that summer seemed to last forever. And if I had the choice, then I would always be there. Those were the best days of my life. Ain't no use in complaining when you've got a job to do. I spent my evenings down at the drive-in, and that's where I met you. Standing on your mama's porch, you told me that we'd last forever. And when you held my hand, I knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life.
By the British pop song, Do They Know It's Christmas, the American pop song, We Are the World, and Canada too was there to lend a hand with Tears Are Not Enough, produced by Victoria's David Foster.
Yes, in 1985, Canada was there to lend a hand. Of course we were. Only 4 years earlier, we lent an entire arm to the International Space Station. In 1988, Calgary hosted the world of the 22nd Winter Olympics, Winter Games, written by David Foster and featuring our house band, was the theme song.
Thank you.
heard around the world came in 1991 when the mayor of Toronto, Jimmy Rollins, thought it was inappropriate at the New Year's Eve celebrations, a family event, to have the bare naked ladies play. The press had their story and the clown princes of Canadian pop music were born.
If I had $1 million,
if I had $1 million,
I'd buy you a house.
I would buy you a house.
If I had $1 million,
if I had $1 billion,
I'd buy you furniture for your house.
Maybe not just a field or nothing.
If I had $1 million,
if I
if you're going by
Music has always been an important part in the lives of Maritimers. In 1993, the Rankins released this song, which speaks the resiliency that Cape Bretoners show in times of hardship, drawing strength from friends, family, and music. Winter sport and the birth of Justin Bieber. 1994 also gave
1995, Alanis Morissette released Jagged Little Pill, which went to sell 15 million copies. Nothing ironic about that.
Still the one I
Fellown produced the band Great Big Sea, and their 1997 song Ordinary Day describes Newfoundlanders to a T. They ask nothing of the world, yet offer everything to it.
Home of Canada's Susan Aglukkaq, who in 1995 recorded
recorded this song.
Sarah McLaughlin was born and raised in Halifax, moving to Vancouver to pursue a recording career. The rest is history.
You get it, you turn it.
Voice has meant a trip down the 401 to Toronto. However, this 2010 song by the Troops tells about the final trip down the 401 that too many of our fallen soldiers have had to make.
People above, with
also a fan of life and
you can dance every dance with the guy who gives you the eye. Let him hold you tight. Every smile for the man who held your hand beneath the pale moonlight. And don't forget who's taking you home, or in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, save the last dance for me.
From Vancouver's Winter Olympic Games, I believe, or en français, j'imagine.
There comes a moment when my heart must stand alone on this lonely path I've chosen, like a house that's not home. Mais quelques fois quand j'en ai assez, que je sens ta tu t'abandonner. Tu veux que je sois ce que je suis. Je fonce alors je te dis. I believe in the power of God. This is the moment.
1985, Canadian artists came together to help the famine in Africa. After the devastating 2010 earthquake in Haiti, Canadian artists once again came together to re-record K-Non's Waving Flag. Tonight's performance will have original lyrics by Corbin Flowers.
Success is like fighting a war. Tell me I'm shining so bright, but someone will feel that I'm moving to go. They don't want me to succeed. Try to keep me from the keys. Try to keep me in the war zone. Someone want me to have peace. Man, I've been running, been living me. Haters been making conspiracies. Haters been plotting and scheming. I woke up the dream of believing the fantasies. Someone want me to be happy. Act like the day when I'm sad. So within they wait for the day that I blow, but then I can tell I'm too bad. Struggling, I cannot eat. I hear them say, love is the way, so I'll keep on fighting like Canada Day. When I get older, I will be stronger, they'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back, oh, oh, oh. Yeah, I'm in pain, life is a game, living the struggle, I go through each day. They say there's hope, but where did it go? Dreamer, hot as a fever, blocking the hate out, that's my demeanor. No, they can't hold me, no, they can't fold me now. We gon' pick it up even though we still struggling. I cannot eat and I'm wondering if you're the same once you're free. I hear them say, love is the way, so I'll keep on fighting like Canada.
Canadian Idol, but she won the hearts of millions with her song, Call Me Maybe.
I threw a wish in a well, don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as I fell, and I ran that way. I trained myself for a wish, and easing down for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, and now you're in that way. Your stare was molded, ripped jeans, skin was shoulder. Thank you.
skyrocketing to success? It started with Palenka, and then along came a kid named Justin Bieber.
Forgiveness. I know you know that I made those mistakes maybe once or twice. And by once or twice, I mean maybe a couple of hundred times. So let me redeem or redeem all myself tonight. Cause I just need one shot at second chances.
You're
Canadian musicians have become heroes to many. Brampton's Alyssa Cara became the champion to youth everywhere with her 2016 release, Scars to Your Beautiful.
Tragically hit.
honored guests, the students of the Limestone District School Board. You've popped enough, it's okay. Once-in-a-lifetime learning opportunities like the Canadian Crystal could not happen without the unwavering support of our sponsors. Would you please welcome to the stage presenting sponsor for Johnson Insurance, represented this evening by Catherine Turner.
Thanks to the generosity of all of tonight's event sponsors, students like the ones we've seen perform here and have met this evening will benefit in the coming months and years from many more Limestone Learning Foundation programs. Johnson Insurance, known locally to many of you as Johnson, Jem and Vogelzang, is committed to educators across Canada. We support students in their endeavors, and we're committed to helping and supporting the Limestone Learning Foundation through events like the Canadian Crystal, which is an important part of demonstrating our commitment to education. To those of you here tonight who are just learning about the Limestone Learning Foundation and like what you see and hear, or have given a donation before, perhaps you'll consider making a pledge this evening to ensure excellence in education continues. Please consider joining like-minded patrons like Dr. John and Mrs. Catherine Leverett, Mrs. Pamela and Mr. Kevin Hart, and Morven construction owner Marie Aitken, who have all come forward to be a part of tonight's gala giving. If you're interested in making a donation, you can do so by visiting the Canadian Crystal Giving Area at the bottom of the stairs out in the lobby. Johnson Insurance is very proud to be the presenting sponsor of the Canadian Crystal, and I'm thrilled to be able to reintroduce these amazing students to perform O Canada Canadian Crystal Finale.
Free.
Lundy, our music director, Tim Stiff, and assistant music director, Greg Runyons.